And then justify your choice of reward structure for one of the positions outlined in question five. So then you might say, okay, marketing manager, I'm just going to choose this one, and then I'm going to justify why did I choose this base pay, why did I choose variable performance pay, why did I choose these benefits, and why did I choose these allowances. Again, that's with 4 marks, and you have to give 4 justifications. Okay, so think about things raised in case study, equity of rewards, what you might know about sort of industry practice in that area. Don't overthink all of this. Should be too, just have a go. And that's it. It was only 1 page, only 6 questions. Only 6 questions. Any questions about this assignment? There's a wee multi-choice quiz there for you to have a go at. If you want to have a go at that one now, and then we'll finish up. 10 off. Okay?
Yeah.
You're done? Okay, through them. Which of the following is not an example of an intrinsic reward?
It's an interesting word. Right?
Not an example, no. Thumbs up from the boss is not an example of intrinsic because it's extrinsic, it comes from outside of yourself. Intrinsic is stuff that comes from inside of yourself. So the sense that your work is interesting, your personal growth, your sense of accomplishment is all sort of more intrinsic. Which is not an example of an extrinsic reward.
Sense of responsibility.
Good, yes. D, sense of responsibility. All the others are external to self. The World at Work Total Rewards model has 5 elements, which is not one of them.
Share ownership.
Good, Jemima. Yeah, so remuneration, work-life balance, development, career opportunities, and a couple others are part of the Total Rewards model. Internal relativity refers to remuneration that is fair and consistent within the organisation.
True.
Yay.
Yes.
And external comparability, therefore, is remuneration that is influenced by what competitors are prepared to pay.
True.
So equity theory says people act on the belief that a certain amount of effort will lead to a certain level of performance and then to desirable outcomes or rewards.
True.
False. Tricked you. That would be expectancy theory. Equity theory is the next one where people are motivated by the desire for a fair social exchange. So both of those are false because they're the opposite of each other. I'm just getting more confused now, not less, aren't I?
Yeah.
Right. Which of the following is not one of the remuneration structures discussed in the book? Good, yes, because it's a job evaluation method. The two main types of job evaluation are?
B.
Analytical and non-analytical. Good. The Hay Guide chart profile method uses the following 3 dimensions.
C.
It was C. Know-how, problem solving and accountability. Which is not part of base pay?
Team-based
rewards. Yeah, all of the others were. Which is not part of variable or contingent pay? Time-based pay. Yeah, good. Because that's base pay. 3 categories of benefits, which are? A, general, immediate, and deferred. And market allowances allow organisations to pay above a salary grade or band for a specific job. True or false?
False.
False. True. That's exactly what market allowances do.
That's why I thought was it leader was above.
Yeah, that's when you're being a paid leader. Yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely. But a market allowance, when we talk about allowances, a market allowance, or sometimes called a spot rate, is where we pay above a salary. And because we can't get anybody to do the job for that rate, because the industry rates are higher.
Yeah.
And it does raise issues of equity within that internal relativity. But, you know, if we can't actually recruit somebody without that additional, and that's why we call it an allowance often, is, you know, it's a market allowance to recognise that. You wouldn't take this job otherwise.
The biotech would probably be a classic example of, well, I don't know whether it would really be, but the thing is, like, a digger operator is getting $30 an hour at the mine working.
He's why would they come and teach digger driving if you get paid less than that? Yeah, exactly.
In that way.
Yeah, it is a classic example. There might be other reasons, you know, for people to move from that sort of job. You know, it might be physical conditions, or, you know, teaching might be it.
Yeah.
more in line with somebody's career path or ambitions or whatever. So there might be other reasons that motivate people to do that. But if the pay rate is too out of line with what industry will pay, then yeah, it's hard to recruit good people.
All right, so that's us. And next week we've got...